Hello, my name is Ivan, and I would like to show you today how to pack a laptop correctly if you sold it online and you want to make sure that your laptop will be delivered in undamaged as described condition. First of all, I want to talk about why it is important to pack your laptop or some other device that you sold online. It is pretty simple. Let's say you sold a laptop, it is in a pretty much good condition and the screen is not damaged and no cracks on it and so on. And let's say you as a seller selling not that often, a few times maybe a year or maybe only once a year, and let's say you packed it not well and the item arrived damaged. The question is, what's gonna happen if the buyer will receive the item that is not as described? It can lead to some situations where you need to, you will lose some money. And that's why I decided to make this video to show some ways of packing laptop that in my opinion will make the shipping process better. So we will start with 11 10-inch laptop, and this is a Chromebook HP that will be packed. So basically, if you send it, sell it via eBay, let's say, and then you will purchase the labels via eBay, and that will be cheaper because some people, they selling on eBay but they do not purchase a label on eBay for some reason. They go to post office and they pay there some bigger money without any discounts, and that is kind of questionable why they are doing it. But let's say you purchase a label from eBay, that will be either USPS priority label or it will be FedEx SmartPost. Obviously, not every seller who sells sometimes on eBay have a lot of packing material. So they, before they will even starting to sell something, they need to figure out how I'm gonna pack this thing. Because looks like some sellers, they just think like, oh, I'm gonna sell it, then I will think how to pack it, and this is a bad idea. Before you start to sell something, you need to be prepared to pack it also. You need to have a box, you need to have some sort of bubble wrap or some packing paper or whatever to make sure that you will be able right away pack your item and ship it. Two simple ways to pack. You can either use some used bubble wrap that you got from other sellers when you purchase something on eBay or Amazon or some other sites, or you can use some paper like that, or you use combination of these packing supplies. So let's say you can use the paper, the bubble wrap, the used bubble wrap like that, wrap it and tape it, and then you can get some sort of box. This box, for example, will fit perfectly, but inside you can stick some amount of paper, and by doing that you will make sure that laptop will be safe and will not hit the walls of the box. So this is pretty easy and safe operation that can be made, and you don't need a lot of material. But depends on the condition. Depends on the condition of the laptop. If, for example, it's in a fairly good condition, I would not suggest to ship it only in such a box because it's kind of small and so on. If it's in a good condition, because there is a flat rate priority that might cost even cheaper than FedEx SmartPost sometimes. So you will pack it in a flat rate box, and there's still some space inside of this box in between another box. And this, you can stick some other bubble wrap or some other protecting material inside of it, then close it and pack it and ship it. Like that, it will be much, much more secure than just in one box. So that's how I probably would ship a little laptop like that. Plus, there is, in between the boxes, there is a space for the, let's say, charger, if you're selling it with the charger. Now I want to talk to you about the 15-inch regular size, pretty much regular size and the most popular size of the laptop. It is a 15-inch Toshiba laptop. It actually has a broken screen, but we definitely will pack it also the best. There is a also a few ways to pack it. The inside packing material is pretty much the same, either some used bubble wrap or the packing paper. For example, recently somebody used a some used Amazon box with some used bubble wrap, and they placed the laptop inside. It was also wrapped in some little bubble wrap, but they used also these bubbles, air bubbles, that they probably got collected from Amazon or something when they purchased something, or some other eBay sellers. By packing like that, laptop was pretty secure because bubbles didn't move anywhere and the laptop was not hitting the walls of the box. So it was greatly secured in such a box. And the box was enough size for the 15-inch 15-inch laptop. Some people you are using the large flat rate box. It is not a bad idea to use a flat rate box because you always know the price, how much you pay for shipping. But it has a huge con because especially this flat rate box, a large flat rate box from USPS is very fragile, let's say, because although on the sides this ends of the box are pretty sturdy and will not be broken as easy as some used boxes, because it's very good. In the middle of this box, it's just unbelievable how easy it can be damaged and bended and whatever else can happen to this box. So once it got bended this way, it will be bended all the time. And if you have 15-inch laptop inside of this box, you can imagine what type of damages can occur to this laptop if you are using the large flat rate box. So be careful with large flat rate boxes. If you want to send something in the large flat rate box, find the box that can fit in a large flat rate box. In this case, it will be more secure. Otherwise, do not use it on the only box you can use it. The best package probably that can be is a some used box from some other selling stores like Amazon or in other eBay sellers. And for example, this Amazon box will be perfect place for your laptop to ship it somewhere, because it will have lots of space in between a laptop and the walls of the box, so you can safely pack it and ship it without any worry. If the laptop that you send is super expensive, you may also use some additional box to place it and ship it with some cheap FedEx Smart Post or some cheap UPS label as well. Now we can talk about a huge 17-inch laptop. And this poor guy had a huge problem because it was sold as a pretty much good laptop, had only some sort of wires on a hard drive, and I purchased it happily, like, hey, I will get a Republic of Gamers edition laptop for myself for like $250. And I purchased it, and what upset me that the guy packed this laptop in only Amazon box like that. And finally, and as you can see, it is definitely an overkill to pack the huge and heavy laptop in some used box like that, because finally box end up damaged, laptop inside of this box end up damaged as well. It got some structural damages here on by the USB port, and it also damaged some internal components on the motherboard. So the video card, video chip was damaged, and it's not working anymore as it was described. Doing so, the buyer, the seller, basically have to refund some money in order to keep their promise, kind of, I don't know how to tell it, but because I was definitely upset that the laptop ended up damaged because of some kind of sloppy packing. For the expensive and big and heavy laptops, it will be better to use either double box, so you still can use this used box and place your laptop in it and pack it well, but it will not be only one box that you will use for this laptop. For example, the post office sometimes ships their boxes packing material that you can get actually for free on the post office or the USPS.com. They ship it sometimes in the huge cardboard box like that. This cardboard box can be used as additional box for your big, huge, heavy, expensive laptop. Then you can inside one box into another one, maybe add some additional layer of packing filling inside of the box, maybe even the peanuts, peanuts like that, they call it peanuts, right? And you can add it there and it will also work out well and protect your expensive laptop much better than just little one box, because obviously it is not enough. But there are a few other ideas that you can use in order to pack your laptop well. For example, there are boxes you can purchase, I guess, even in a FedEx station that are specifically made for the laptop transportation. And it has some inserts, this cardboard with a plastic film that can be stretched, and you can stick your laptop inside of it, and then when you place this filling into the box, the laptop will be 100% secured. From one side is there's a cardboard and the space. From the other side there will be also a space for your laptop to be safe. This box can be closed and shipped with FedEx, SmartPost, or some other shipping services that are cheaper. You need to understand that most buyers, they probably prefer the cheapest way to get the item rather than fastest way to get the item, because they understand that if you want to ship it fast, you will pay more money. It means the buyer will pay more money, unless the seller is stupid and he will just put some price and he will forget that to ship a laptop will cost something. But this then will be a seller's issue and not a buyer issue. This sort of box with a film, I'm sure there are some bigger boxes like that, but you will probably need to also buy the box like that, or you will need to save the box like that in order to ship your own laptop somewhere. But for it, this box with the film, for example, will not suit huge laptop needs, because this laptop is too huge, wouldn't be able to fit in this type of packing. So in this case, you can use some other type of custom box. And this box with some sort of packing filling like that, you can, and here inserts can be removed, and you can basically create a space exactly needed for your laptop. For example, here we removed a few inserts, and we easily can pack our laptop into the box, and it will be already much better protected from all kind of outer impacts. We can place this cushion over here, close it, and believe me, this will be much better packing method for this huge 17-inch laptop. Another important thing to consider is what boxes not to use. So basically avoid to use a little or completely damaged and old boxes with your shaping, because If box is too damaged, then your item will arrive damaged too. Also, try not to do that way. You see here the same boxes, but one I'm closing a regular way, how it should be closed. And it's pretty little box. It's not a flat rate, it's just a regular priority box. And some little laptop might fit here, but then it will be more expensive to sand it because it weighed by pounds and not a flat rate. But here we can see the same box and how it was closed by another seller. Here we see that instead of closing it all the way, he made extended the, basically let's call it doors of the box as the walls, and made the doors a little bit smaller, so it was closed that way instead of this way, and it became a bit bigger. It is of course a nice idea to extend your box because you don't have other boxes, but maybe you can make a trip to a post office and get a bigger box, because this box was smashed all the way like this way, and not ripped, but still was like not in a pleasant condition when I got a laptop. And my question is just, you know, how would you want to your item arrive to you if you purchase somewhere? If you want to arrive in a box like this way, okay, then pack it that way. But then don't be surprised if somebody's treating you as an idiot and asking you for some sort of refund, or telling you, don't be surprised that your laptop or something you send it to someone is broken, because obviously it will be broken if you're using box in a not appropriate way. Few other things to consider is, if you like packing a laptop, do not stick anything, like let's say you want to protect the screen, and do not stick the bubble wrap in between the screen and the palm rest. Believe it or not, some people doing it and they putting it that way, and they just simply do not realize that it can either damage some plastic parts inside of the laptop, or it can also damage the screen, or it can bend the hinges, and so it will be practically less usable after all. I wouldn't say it wouldn't be fixable, but it will be less usable. So nothing, place nothing in between the screen and the palm rest, because it can damage the inserts of the laptop. Another very important moment is when you are setting your laptop with a charger. For example, here we got a charger, and you saw it with laptop, it's very good, but then never place a charger somewhere in this place, over here, or over here, because especially at the place where the screen is located, if box will be damaged somehow and there will be some sort of pressure, it can damage the screen, and then again you will have some consequences because of that damage. The best probably place is to pack your charger is somewhere here, or maybe the cables first, that if something will press, nothing will be really damaged, because it maybe is not a working broken laptop. So you really don't have to be too careful, but if it has a good screen and somebody purchased it for the good screen, then it should be placed over, it shouldn't be placed over here, because obviously it's not a good idea. It's a common sense, guys, but some people, unfortunately, not like you and me, they don't have a common sense, they packing it somehow weird. And the last thing I would say, it's not that important, but it's nice to make. Use some sort of fragile sticker on your box, because you know, you might argue and say, hey Ivan, nobody needs these fragile stickers, because at the post office or some other places where they where they working with the packages, they do not really look at the fragile stickers, that they don't care. But in my honest opinion, you're using the fragile stickers not for yourself, you're using your fragile stickers not for the post workers. The fragile stickers are simply used for your buyer, because if the buyer will get a box and it will be very well packed, and it will even, and it's not just it will have some fragile, no, it will even have a fragile stickers, then the buyer will differently look at the whole item that is inside. So I think that's all. I hope I give you guys some sort of ideas how to pack your device as well. Just do it right, and this step, the packing step, is probably one of the most important steps in the online sale. And if you cannot use some sort of expensive boxes that can protect your device as well, just use your common sense and pack it well, and this part of the sale will go smoothly for sure. I hope you enjoyed the show. Thank you very much, and I see you next time. Bye bye.